In this video, we're going to talk about how to measure the ordinary high water mark on a property with no or few field indicators. For this example, we're going to measure the ordinary high water mark here at a location where we have field indicators, and then we're going to go to the beach that's behind me where there are no field indicators, and we're going to transfer that ordinary high water mark measurement over to the beach area. So the first thing you need to do when you're going to measure the ordinary high water mark is to gather some tools. And these should be tools that you probably have around your house somewhere. One of the things you're going to need is a measuring tape. Another thing you'll need is some kind of level. What I have here is a line level, but you can also use a level that you might have in your garage. And the third thing you're going to need is something straight and level and long enough that it would extend from the shoreline out over the water surface. So there's a few different things that you could use. You could use a broom handle. You could use a piece of wood that you might have. You could use a level that you might have in your garage. And what I'm going to use today for this purpose is a survey rod. Next, we want to talk about when to measure the ordinary high water mark. You want to make your measurements on a calm day when there isn't any wind that's creating waves crashing on the shoreline. A day like this where there's a little breeze and a little bit of water surface interference is fine. You can still get a good measurement. The next thing you want to watch out for is boat wakes. You want to make sure that you wait until the water is calmed down before you take your measurements. And lastly, you want to make sure that you take all your measurements on the same day so that the water elevation is consistent. Now that you have the proper tools to measure the ordinary high water mark, I'm going to walk you through the steps of the measurements that you need to take. First, you want to find a location on the lake where there's visible evidence of the ordinary high water mark. This is a good location because you can see a definite difference between the lake bed and where you have no vegetation and the sandy slope that comes up to an area where you have vegetation growing. This is where you're going to find your ordinary high water mark, and this is a good location to measure it. Make sure that you have permission to access the property that you're going to measure the ordinary high water mark on. So let's make our first measurement. The first thing you want to do is take the survey rod and place it at the ordinary high water mark. The next thing you want to do is take your line level and put it on top so that you can hold the survey rod level. Next, you want to measure down from the survey rod to the water surface. This measurement is about 0.2 of a foot. Once you've taken and recorded this measurement, take several more measurements along the ordinary high water mark, along the same shoreline, to see if you're being consistent. If these measurements are consistent, it could be a good indication that you've correctly identified the ordinary high water mark. When you are confident that you know how much higher the ordinary high water mark is than the water surface, return to the property with few or no field indicators of the ordinary high water mark. Now we've returned to the location where there are no or few indicators of the ordinary high water mark, and we need to find the location of the ordinary high water mark on this beach. You'll do this by using the measuring tape to measure up 0.2 of a foot from the water surface, and then using the survey rod, you'll go over to the shoreline 0.2 of a foot above the water surface and find the location of the ordinary high water mark. So take your stadia rod and put it somewhere along the shoreline that you think approximates ordinary high water mark. Get the survey rod level and take a quick measurement to see how far above water surface you are. Okay, we're a little bit too high at 0.3 of a foot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide the survey rod down a little bit. I'm going to keep it level and I'm going to re-measure. And that location is approximately 0.2 of a foot above the water surface. Repeat this measurement at several other points along the beach and mark each location of the ordinary high water mark with a flag or a wooden stake or spray paint so that you can get a good visual representation of the location of the ordinary high water mark. Now let's talk about how to record the location of the ordinary high water mark for a DEQ permit application. If you're planning to submit an application to the DEQ for a construction project at or near the shoreline, you may want to follow these next steps. Take photographs of the markings or field indicators and record measurements of the location of the ordinary high water mark so that it can be located in the future by others who may need to find the location you've identified, such as DEQ or the construction contractor. Photographs should show the location of the ordinary high water mark from several angles, including from offshore if possible. For example, the photo could be taken from a dock or boat or by wading out into the water. After you've taken a few photographs, you may also want to take a few measurements to include with your permit application. Measurements should be recorded from permanent, stationary objects like buildings, large trees, fences, or property markers to the ordinary high water mark. The location of the ordinary high water mark and the measurements you've just taken should be included in your DEQ application on the site drawing. The location of the ordinary high water mark and the measurements you've just taken should be included on your DEQ application on the site drawings. Thanks for watching our video series. For more information, go to our website at www.michigan.gov/DEQ Inland Lakes.